There are moments in the history of science where silence becomes louder than any explosion. And this is one of them. It wasn't an asteroid, a dying star, or a newborn galaxy that triggered the alarm. It was the faint whisper of the universe's infancy. The James Webb Space Telescope, orbiting a million miles from Earth and gazing deeper into the universe than any human-made instrument before, was observing a sector of space previously thought to be a sparse void, a quiet expanse between galaxies, just a dim patch in the cosmic map. But what it found there shattered that assumption. In one of the emptiest parts of the cosmos, the telescope detected light from galaxies so ancient they challenge our understanding of the universe's birth. And then something even stranger happened. These galaxies, seen as they were just 280 million years after the Big Bang, revealed structures that moved scientists to rethink the timeline of cosmic evolution. What the telescope recorded next forced a team of astrophysicists, cosmologists, and mathematicians to refine known models of reality. Because this was no comet, no pulsar, no black hole. This was something else. Something that reshapes our view of how galaxies form, how stars ignite, and perhaps how the universe itself began. This is the story of what James Webb just uncovered in the deep. A discovery so profound in its implications, so remarkable in its physics, that scientists have begun whispering the unthinkable. What if the universe formed faster than we ever imagined? It all began during a deep field survey near the Eridanus supervoid, a vast, almost mythic region of space known for its mysterious cold spots and unusually low galaxy density. While calibrating infrared sensors for a galaxy mapping project, the James Webb Telescope picked up an anomaly that was too structured to be random, yet too complex to be simple. Instead of seeing only distant galaxies or interstellar gas, the telescope detected a cluster of galaxies, including one dubbed MOMZ14, existing just 280 million years after the Big Bang. No light was obscured, no void consumed it. This was gravitational lensing at its finest, amplifying the light of galaxies from a time when the universe was a mere infant. Picture dropping ink into a still glass of water and watching ripples form intricate patterns. That's what the data showed. A region not just filled with matter, but brimming with the earliest structures of the cosmos. Initial theories suggested these might be typical early galaxies, but the data didn't align with expectations. These galaxies were massive, with stars already formed, defying models that predicted slower formation. And then, over the course of several observations, the light from these galaxies revealed chemical signatures, elements heavier than expected for such an early epoch. Scientists from multiple institutions began analyzing the light echoes surrounding these galaxies. And what they found was more unsettling than any black hole or supernova could ever be. The spectra of distorted light that rippled from these objects weren't random. They showed patterns of heavy elements, like carbon and oxygen, suggesting star formation had occurred far earlier than models predicted. First detected in small galaxies, then in larger ones, these signatures followed a sequence, as if the universe was building complexity at an astonishing pace, as if the galaxies weren't just existing, they were evolving. but evolving into what? What's more, these signals weren't just electromagnetic. They were infrared, captured by Webb's sensitive instruments, revealing the chemical makeup of stars born billions of years ago. The telescope's spectrographs recorded shifts in wavelength that coincided with each galaxy's light burst. Like something was nudging the story of cosmic evolution forward. It didn't just challenge the rules of astrophysics. It expanded them. Mathematicians were brought in. Astrophysicists pored over the data. The conclusion? These were not typical stellar nurseries, but the fingerprints of rapid cosmic growth. No known galaxy formation model fully explains this. Not quasars, not dark matter clumps, not even primordial gas clouds. The precision was remarkable, the patterns unmistakably structured, and some believe these galaxies might hold clues to processes we've yet to understand. Then came the moment no one expected. In a follow-up observation conducted precisely 27 days after the first detection, the James Webb team observed a shift. The galaxies, once thought to be static snapshots of the past, revealed dynamic changes. They hadn't moved through space, but their light had shifted further into the infrared, a sign of their immense distance and the universe's expansion. They reappeared in Webb's field of view, redshifted by 0.004, an imperceptible fraction to the human eye, but monumental to the calculations of scientists. Because if galaxies form this early, this massive, it means they're not bound by the timelines we assumed. It means cosmic evolution was faster, more efficient. The only known parallel to this kind of phenomenon exists in simulations of the early universe, where dark matter scaffolds enabled rapid galaxy formation. But these weren't simulations. These were structures the size of modern galaxies, behaving as if the laws of cosmic growth were accelerated. When astrophysicists modeled the growth, they found something even more unnerving. The pattern of their formation suggested a cascade, pointing to a universe that was more interconnected in its infancy than we thought. By the fourth month of analysis, the team was no longer asking whether these galaxies were unusual. They were asking how they formed so quickly. Spectral patterns around MOMZ14 began to stabilize into complex formations, echoing the hierarchical growth of cosmic structures, not like stars or gas clouds, but like networks of dark matter and gas. The longer the telescope stared, the more the patterns evolved, adapting to the sensor's orientation, revealing new details in real time, almost like the universe was adjusting its story as we watched. Scientists coined a term for this behavior: accelerated cosmology. Some speculated these galaxies might be the seeds of massive structures like galaxy clusters, or even the precursors to our own Milky Way. One AI model, trained to simulate galaxy formation, struggled with the telescope's data. It processed, recalibrated, and finally returned a probability score: likely. The message was clear, though no one said it aloud. This isn't just a discovery, it's a new chapter in cosmic history. After weeks of capturing more data, the Webb team noticed a curious phenomenon, not in the galaxies themselves, but in the surrounding field. A background radiation shift, almost imperceptible at first, began to emerge. Unlike cosmic microwave background or localized bursts from stars, this signal was synchronized with the galaxy's light, but delayed, as if we were witnessing an echo of their formation. Spectral analysis confirmed something remarkable. The signal contained chemical layers that shouldn't be there so early. Metals forged in the hearts of stars long dead. Frequencies arranged not by random emission, but in structured intervals reminiscent of stellar evolution. Some scientists began calling it the song of the cosmos, but others were more pragmatic. A signal like this, they said, is impossible without rapid star formation and death. Not a chaotic process, but a structured one. More intriguingly, the spectral harmonics shifted slightly with Webb's positional changes. This led to a bold hypothesis. The signal wasn't static. It was dynamic, revealing how these galaxies grew in real time. It was illuminating, measuring, echoing back, as if the universe wasn't just shining. It was unfolding. Amid the growing excitement behind the scenes, a group of theoretical cosmologists was brought in to analyze the numerical structure of the spectra, and that's when everything changed. Hidden within the signal's wavelength sequence was an embedded pattern that resonates with known cosmic phenomena. The distribution of galaxies followed a logarithmic spiral, a configuration that echoes the large-scale structure of the universe today. But here it was, repeated exactly in the early universe's layout. Some scientists believed it might be a universal blueprint, a kind of cosmic scaffolding, a foundation for structure formation. If this pattern was there, it would mean the universe's architecture was set far earlier than we thought. And what came next deepened the wonder. When the distribution was graphed in three dimensions, it formed a complex web, one nearly identical to the cosmic web of filaments and voids we see today. Coincidence? Perhaps. But when scientists ran the numbers, they realized the spacing of these galaxies matched models of dark matter distribution. Something wasn't just forming. Something was orchestrating a universe we're only beginning to understand. That's when the scientific community took notice. Publicly available, Webb data streams began to spark global interest. Access logs from research observatories saw unprecedented traffic, and key scientists involved in the study were inundated with inquiries. Press releases from the agencies involved, NASA, ESA, CSA, shifted in tone. Once cautious, they now brimmed with enthusiasm for the new data. Insiders reported that international space agencies were pulled into collaborative meetings, including the European Space Agency, NASA, and even private entities like SpaceX, not because the discovery posed a threat, but because it demanded a unified effort to understand. Theories began to multiply. Was this a glimpse of the universe's first galaxies? A blueprint for cosmic evolution? The timing of the discovery was striking in itself. It appeared only after we had developed instruments capable of seeing it, meaning these galaxies had always been there, waiting for us to catch up. But perhaps the most intriguing detail was this. Earlier telescopes, like Hubble, had peered into this region without detecting such structures, which means these galaxies were either too faint for older instruments or their light was only now reaching us. The final act, as always, comes quietly. On the 48th day of targeted Webb observation, just before the telescope was scheduled to switch to another region of space, something changed. The galaxy's signatures stabilized. No new shifts. No new distortions. Just clarity. But before that clarity settled in, Webb's sensors captured one last image, an infrared composite unlike anything seen before. It wasn't a shadow. It wasn't a distortion. It was a tapestry of galaxies, perfectly proportioned, like a cosmic mosaic. It lasted through several frames, enough for detailed analysis. Artificial intelligence confirmed the structures were not random. They were geometric, composed of clustered galaxies, filaments, and voids forming a recursive pattern. And then the observation window closed. Since then, the data has been pored over, but the galaxies remain. The clarity remains. And perhaps most exciting of all, the possibility remains that whatever this was, whatever is out there, is still shining, waiting for us to look again. So, what did James Webb really see out there? A glimpse of the universe's infancy? A blueprint for the cosmic web we inhabit today? Or maybe a chapter of creation we were never meant to read so soon? The profound truth is this: the deeper we stare into the cosmos, the more it reveals its secrets. What we once believed to be a slow, chaotic birth is now starting to look like a structured symphony. And maybe, just maybe, the universe is ready to share its story. This discovery isn't about space alone anymore. It's about what we're ready to understand. It's about the possibility that we've opened a window to the universe's earliest moments using light, pattern, and precision. And the best part? We're still learning what it's telling us. One thing is certain: James Webb didn't just capture data, it opened a door. And what's waiting behind it may rewrite everything we thought we knew. Not just about the universe, but about our place in it. If this story made you curious about what's out there and what discoveries await, don't forget to like this video, subscribe for more cosmic insights, and hit the bell icon so you never miss a moment when the universe reveals itself again. Because this isn't science fiction anymore. This is science evolving.